Alright guys, we're back, and we're in the next part of Grand Theft Auto 5. Welcome back, episode 5. We're coming here to, we're gonna do something with Michael. And let's see what we can get. So we got this to open up on us, which is nice. I didn't know he had a truck. That's really nice.
Oh, I did know he had a truck.
$250
now to fuck my wife and my old bed?
Hey, you! Stop it!
What's up, man? Get out of my way.
Michael, calm down.
What the fuck is going on?
Nothing happened. It was a misunderstanding.
She fucked a brick in my bed.
You bullshitting me.
It wasn't like that.
You in?
Fuck it, I'm in. Let's roll. Let's get this motherfucker.
Just don't kill him!
All right, I guess we're playing as Michael.
You okay, homie? What happened? The guy bounced my wife is what happened.
Which guy?
The guy I'm paying to teach her tennis.
The tennis coach? Oh, that's fucked up, man. Who is dudes, homie? You know, back in the hood, man, we gotta watch out for the mailman, dog.
Yeah, I'm a cuckold, a snob, and a...
Oh, I'm so used to being Franklin.
A fucking cliche.
Ain't you looking?
I ain't gonna let him get away.
Technically we are, because I took the wrong turn. And
he ain't slipping this noose.
Fuck, man, I think we lost his leg.
He lives somewhere up in the canyon. We'll find him.
How you catch?
It wasn't hard. They were in my house. In my own bed. On top of each
other. Oh shit!
On top of each other.
Man, this dude got some spine in his head.
The whole thing was kind of self-explanatory, Frank. And what we're about to do won't need much context either.
Shit, let's go coast the shit out of this motherfucker.
Well, that wasn't very well.
You crashed!
Well, I think we're kind of stuck here, which really sucks. Nope, there we go.
You get kind of reckless, homie.
About that. I didn't figure out how to restart it. So we'll just say Jeff Franklin's. Okay, I would like to. Really? You're not gonna let me? Okay, this is how you do it then. Fail it like that. This time we'll actually take the right turn. So, yeah.
You okay, homie? What happened?
The guy bounced my wife is what happened.
Which guy?
The guy I'm paying to teach her tennis.
The tennis coach? Oh, that's fucked up, man. Who is dudes, homie? You know, back in the hood, man, we gotta watch out for the mailman, dog.
Yeah, I'm a cuckold, a snob, and a fucking cliche.
All right, there we go. Instead of turning here, he went straight.
He went left up here, dog.
I wish I was still driving with Franklin, though, because I can't drive worth a shit. But it's all good. Motherfucker, I'm trying. This motherfucker truck's so fucking slow. It's a goddamn Dodge. What do you expect? Give me a fucking Ford and we'll be on his ass.
Man, I think we lost his head.
He lives somewhere up in the canyon. We'll find him.
Right, there we go.
You see that little piece of shit?
Well. I wish I could drive. I don't know what Franklin's... Not Franklin, but Michael's special
is. This track here.
Hey! One of these fucking houses.
Yeah, keep your eye out.
Hey,
That's his car, right there.
Little prick's up there, look.
Oh, shit, Cole's doing all right for himself.
Hey, asshole! You ran off before we could settle our debt!
Michael, what? You got the wrong idea, man!
He's about to have a real clear idea where I'm coming from. There's a winch in the back of the truck. Tied a cable to one of those supports up there.
You finna pull his deck down?
Hey, that prick pulled my marriage down.
Man, you really gonna be this fucking dramatic?
Yeah, whatever.
I told you I comped the session, bud!
Well, there were a lot of freaking sessions, bud! I'm thinking you were working on more than just her backhand!
Mandy's backhand has come a long way, bro. But sometimes it's gotta get worse to get better.
Yeah, well, maybe I should come up there and practice my backhand! On your face!
Bud, your negative energy is seriously bringing me down.
Oh, I hope it is, bud.
We hooked up, man.
You come into my house, take my money, and nail my wife? Are you fucking kidding me?
I'm gonna stick up my hand and say that was uncool, bud. My bad. Seriously.
Oh, how fucking magnanimous. May I please offer you my applause? You fucking motherfucker!
Dude!
And we'll see how you like it when someone fucks with your shit!
Well, hey, wait! You got the wrong idea, pal! Whoa! Fuck!
Here we go! Ha-ha! Let's see what happens!
Dude, you are properly crazy! Oh, hell yeah, homie! You know what time it is!
Oh, shit! You see this shit, dog? Do it, man! Fucking do it!
That's what I'm fucking talking about.
Man, I think this shit's coming down, man! Man, get some force on that motherfucker! Oh, fuck!
That's how you do it! Damn, the floor and everything!
Yeah! Fuck, come on!
Fuck, man, fuck!
Oh, we did it! Fuck his ass!
Yeah, fuck him. But was we really trying to pull that dude house off the fucking hill?
Hey, we were trying to teach him a fucking lesson.
Now that's an expensive bitch-ass lesson, man.
Maybe he'll keep it on the court and out of my wife.
Yeah, so sorry about that early blowing the,
hey, it's a service the, to the
thingy
community.
Out there. So, I'm so sorry if you gotta hear all that. It'll be gone here in a couple of seconds.
Mr. DeSanto, what the hell?
That's not my house!
Bullshit. Oh, bro, I couldn't afford a place like that. I'm a tennis coach. I hit balls for a living. I was just hiding there.
Give me a phone! You! You're a dead man! Green light! Green light! Martin Madrazo, give you green light!
Oh, I'm scared, lady. Just fucking terrified.
Well, then we gotta do.
Fucking essays right behind.
You kidding me? Kid, can you do something?
I'll give it a go, man. Keep driving.
You got a piece. Now's the time to use it.
We got a book, man. Go.
How much distance we got between us?
Move.
You gotta use that gun?
Hey, let's go. Let's leave him behind. I got one. Pop that dude. We got a book, man. Go.
Can you see him? Are they still back there?
Man, we gotta move.
All right, we managed to lose them.
Hey, let's go. Let's leave them behind. I think we lost them.
Okay, we go back to my house and think about this. Wow, shit. You did good. I mean, your aim's all over the place, but you were a help.
Thanks. I guess.
Hey, don't get the fence. Go to a shooting range. Work on your aim. You'll do fine.
Oh, fuck, man. Shit, you good?
Fine as wine. We got a few knocks. You okay? I mean, you did good, kid.
Man, I'm cool, man. I mean, you. Mentally.
Mentally? Oh, man. I'm fucking excellent. My heart ain't pumped like that in years. Oh, yes! Fucking A, Bubba!
Man, you sound kind of manly. You just been greenlit by the Mexican underworld ambassador to Los Santos.
Trust me. We handled it. Wherever the fuck Martin Madrazo is, I've known worse.
We just handled a few low-ranking crimes.
We sit on it, we see what happens. Kid. Kid, there's no use second-guessing. Hey, thanks for the help out there today, kid. I had no idea it was gonna get that hot.
Shit, pulling houses off the hillside sure has a weird way of fucking with people.
Yeah, well, I thought I was through with all that shit. I don't know what the hell's going on.
Oh, shit. I think we're about to find out.
Do you know who I am? Do you know who I am? Do you?
No.
Who are you? You?
I think so.
Good.
I know who you are. I know where you live. Who are you?
I'm Franklin.
License. Now, Franklin. Maybe help Mr. DeSanta here. Who am I?
I think Martin Madrazo.
Good boy. Now maybe give him a little of a background.
Man, Mr. Madrazo... Mr. Madrazo is a legitimate businessman who was wrongfully accused of running a Mexican-American gang and a narcotic ring, but the charges were dropped because of the witnesses came up missing.
Smart kid. Now, Michael, got a question for you.
Did you pull an architectural, significant, modernist wonder home down the hillside in Vinewood Hills?
I thought the owner was banging my wife.
Well, that was a strange house for a tennis coach.
I wasn't thinking straight.
Clearly.
Yeah.
Well, Natalia will need a hotel while you finance the rebuild, won't she?
Sure.
Good. And I'm guessing here that the rebuild will be somewhere in the 2.5 million range?
Of course.
Great.
That's nice.
Come on, man. Damn, you all right?
Never better.
So what now?
Looks like I'm gonna have to postpone my retirement. Fuck. Ah, man, I'm mortgaged up to my eyeballs. Look, I only know one way to make money. I'm gonna have to give an old friend a call. Lester. I think he's in town somewhere. I'm gonna have to track him down.
All right, we get Lester. Right? Yay.
All right,
dog. I got time for one more mission, and guys, we gotta go. So after this mission, we are going to hopefully do the next episode. Mission passed. That's what I'm talking about.
Hello. Is this still the number for Lester Crest?
Who's asking?
Who's asking? Who's asking?
You're awful cagey. Even for a dead man, Michael.
Ooh, you don't sound good, buddy.
Tactful and charming, even in death. Hey, come see me, old friend. I'm living in Los Santos, just like you. Marietta Heights.
Whoa, whoa, wait. Hey, how do you... Hello? You fucker.
I would just kill somebody's dog. You wanna die? You wanna die today? There you go. Oh, you wanna die today too?
Oh yeah! Thanks, just had to get nasty.
There we go. Alright, well, let's go. We only got one star. We can outrun one star. That's pretty good for the pretty good introduction. Alright guys, we're back and we are doing another mission. So oh snap with Crackle.
Michael, I'm looking through my appointment book and I don't see your name.
Yeah, well, I'm more of a walk-in guy, Doc. You know that.
Walk-ins are more expensive, but I'm always happy to accommodate.
Sure, you'll accommodate me as long as I got money in my pocket, right? I'm in a bad way, Doc. I might come by soon.
We're very different than Radio Mirror Park. Those guys dress.
I like this car!
Alright, well, we gotta hide for right now. We gotta lose these cops. But I wanna get facing the right way, just in case we have to leave.
We've got more music about the anxiety of living in a place with great weather and legal weed.
Oh, poor us. Shit, shouldn't honk the horn. Alright, there we go. Now we can go to Lester's. Where's Lester? Lester's all the way over here. Alright, we get to go into some territory we haven't solved yet. We haven't uncovered yet, let's just say that. I think that'll be a better explanation to say. Oh yeah, look at that, badass. Don't even have to use the special. Oh crap. Now we're jumping on the expressway here. Okay, this is... Alright. Excuse me. Alright, we're on the right path now. Let's go now. Alright. I don't know what to talk about, guys. It's kind of hard when I'm playing this kind of game. I'm usually just waiting for them to talk, but I guess I can figure out something to talk about. It doesn't really matter to me, but leave down in the comments what I should talk about. I'd really like to hear you guys come talk to me, conversate, and yeah, it'd be really nice to see you guys having fun. And me too. I like doing this for you guys. It's pretty cool. And yeah, hopefully we can get some more games going and it'd be lovely. And that's how you gotta drive. Oh yeah. Oh shit, I missed my turn. There we go. Lester lives in the... He's got, like, a whole bunch of money, but he lived, like, right here in the freaking crack houses, dude. Like, really? I forgot what house it is. So... There it is. Got it.
Fuck you, Lester. You gonna let me in or what?
Give me a minute.
There we go. What in the hell?
I was wondering when you'd show up.
I was dead.
Praise be. Guess you weren't very dead. You need my help.
How do you know?
Because you came here. Why else would you?
I haven't been a good friend for you, Lester. I know that.
And you're gonna make it up to me by doing whatever I ask. Or rather, I mean, I need something done, you need to know something, so why not help each other?
I gotta make some dough.
So you're back in the game?
I guess. Look, Lester, about what happened before.
I know you never mentioned my name. I know I'm not on any lists anywhere. I know you never betrayed me. As for you, you gotta figure that I never told anyone. That instead of gently decomposing in North Yankton, you're angrily decomposing in Los Santos with a shrink and a wife who don't love you no more.
Yeah well, since you put it like that...
Hey, shut up a minute. I'm getting an iFind alert. That little college boy sack of shit, phony fuck.
Who? Jay Norris?
Yes. That fuck is a lying bastard. I've read his fucking emails. He's a fucking cheat.
I heard him say that he saved America.
What, by outsourcing all the jobs? By selling us little bits of plastic restricted access shit? Well, now it's payback time, you lying turd.
The hell are you talking about?
You are about to get that white-collar gig that you always dreamed of, Mikey. Here, take this fashionably retro weird for a 45-year-old man, but I cannot let go of the 1980s bag, and dress yourself up like a billionaire math genius with low-level Asperger's. You better be ready for the minor glitch of your repulsive pseudo-messianic life.
Okay, Lester.
Get out of here! Call me when you're ready. We are about to put the Darwinism back in social Darwinism. And brother, it is gonna be fun.
You fucking kidding me? I'm a bank robber, not a web designer.
So we'll go robbing soon. I'll find something. Just like the old days.
I wonder if this was the guy with the curly hair in the beginning.
Please excuse me. I've got something shameful to do.
Alright, there we go. Can we run now? Thank you. Thank you very much. Alright, where do we have to go? We have to go all the way up here. Alright. There we go.
With Sean Douglas, who says he can't wait.
This next phone's going to be the future.
Oh, it also gave us a... Okay. And then we don't need that. If it gave us that. Huh.
Some commentators say that iFruit's glory days are
behind. I thought it was just a dot.
Flood the market, and people remember it's only a phone.
All right,
anyway.
Here we go.
Let's stay on this story, as we literally have no interest in covering the real ones happening at home and abroad.
These laws confirming your prejudices.
This is Vinewood Boulevard Radio.
Shake your some people to leave. I got.
There we go. We'll listen to that. So apparently we gotta go and get dressed up real nice, like $1 million, and probably be going to kill somebody. Hopefully, I like killing people. Killing people is fun, especially on this game. I like it a lot. But there we go. And we're inside. That's nice. Now the hood's gone. That's nice. Thanks. I wonder if that's a V8. Looks like one. I like that blue truck. It's a nice little blue truck. Oh, hit a Dodge Charger. Oops, sorry. And we're gonna come right in here, and there we go. Yeah, there. Now we can walk. We got the 80s bag.
Ah, excuse me. I got this interview at this tech company. I'm thinking I need something, I don't know, geeky, youthful.
Lost your job and the world's moved on, huh? That's too bad.
I didn't lose my job.
Of course. Got too old, got outsourced. Same thing happened to my dad. Now you gotta fit in with a different generation. Hmm? What about a vest and some cargo shorts?
All right.
All right. We'll go with the blue.
Yup, that's as youthful as you're gonna get.
And we'll go with the white for now.
Dignity aside, I think that might just work. Good luck at the interview.
Bye now.
Oh, well, I can't pull out my gun. I'm on a mission. So, alright guys, well, I'm gonna end it here because we're out of time. I thought we would have enough time, but, we will pick up on It's the next episode.
Michael?
I'm all dressed up. Now, you want to run me through this thing?
The prototype is somewhere in the Life Invader office. Find it and fit it with the device in your bag.
They just gonna let me in?
Why wouldn't they if you look the part? Hang around till someone opens the door and act entitled.
Fine.
Alright, well, I guess we'll see you in the next episode. So this is part one of Lester. See you guys in part two, which would be episode 7. This is episode 6, so see you in the next episode.